Hello and welcome to Cloud Tech Talks. This is Pritesh. I'm back with another video. In this video, I'm going to talk about the key differences between the technology stack, something that to relate to from my previous video, where I explained hardware, the evolution from hardware to virtual machines to containers to serverless, which is essentially the future. But in this one, I'm going to do it a little differently. I'm not going to use the technical jargons. I'm not going to use the technology terms which layman cannot understand. The goal for this video is that after you watch it, after you've completed it, you can explain this concept to your 2-year-old, to your 5-year-old, or maybe your 90-year-old grandfather as well. So without wasting further time, let's get started. So to explain this concept, I have written down a few things on the whiteboard, and I will touch on some things which will relate to most of you, you know, when you watch this. And I'm going to touch on some key parameters against things that you and I are very much used to in our daily routine. On one hand, we have four different kinds of homes that we could potentially live in. We have our own apartment, which means we've purchased our own apartment, we are living inside that apartment. Second, we have a rented unfurnished apartment, which means you don't own the home, you just pay rent for it, but you don't have any furniture, which means you bring a lot of stuff in as far as furniture is concerned. The third category is when you rent it out and you get it furnished, fully furnished when you rent it out. And the fourth one is a fully serviced hotel apartment, right? So we are going to look at some key parameters on this side and sort of try to map what we have to invest in and pay for and manage, etc., across all of these four things, and you will see how it later relates to what I really mean. So the first part, goes without saying, investment, from an investment perspective, own home means own home. You have to invest it, which means you're essentially paying a capex investment, which means you're paying, let's say, a million upfront for that, and that's your capex investment. You can't get that back. It's invested already. On the rented, rented unfurnished, rented furnished, and service hotel apartment, all three are based on an opex model, which means you agree with the landlord or the hotel where you pay a fixed fee every month, maybe short term, maybe long term, every year, every quarter as well. All of that can be worked out, but you get the idea. It's not capex. All three other instances are OPEX. The second category is furniture, right? So I clearly mentioned that here it's your own apartment. Obviously, you do need to buy your own furniture, which means you buy here. You buy your own furniture in a empty rented apartment as well, but you don't buy furniture here, and you don't buy furniture in a hotel apartment as well, because it comes fully furnished by default. Then there is a category of cleaning, so which means your household cleaning, all of the dusting that you have to do. Obviously, if it's your own apartment or rented unfurnished or rented furnished, in all three cases, all the first three cases, you have to clean your apartment yourself or hire help to do that, right? So here I will say cleaning needs to be done. Cleaning needs to be done, cleaning needs to be done. But here, the hotel will provide the staff, they will agree with you, they will either clean it twice every week or thrice every week based on the hotel policies, which means you will not have to invest time in cleaning, right? Maintenance, as far as maintenance concerned, a lot of things that we do as far as maintenance is concerned in homes, it could be plumbing, it could be electricity, it could be anything that's got to do with painting or any other kind of work. Obviously, in your own apartment you will do that. In a rented apartment as well, you will have to do that, provided you agree separately with your landlord that he will handle some things himself as and when things come up, or things that have been damaged and you have to replace yourself. You have to take ownership of that and somehow get it done. Get help, but get it done. Rented, furnished as well, same case. You still have to carry on with your maintenance. But in a hotel apartment, you don't need to maintain anything, right? You know, a tap is broken, if anything is not functioning well, even if it's an appliance, you know, a washing machine, a fridge, or anything else in the apartment will straight away get replaced as far as a serviced hotel apartment is concerned. Then comes the service charges. So obviously when you own your own apartment, you do pay your service charges. But when it comes to rented, unfurnished, rented, furnished, you might not need to pay the service charges. And obviously from a hotel apartment perspective, all the fees are included again in this OPEX only. So you don't pay service charges here as well, right? Last but not the least, it's pertaining to planning your capacity, right? So how many people can live in this house, right? Let's say you own a one bedroom. In a one bedroom, if you stretch it out, you can only accommodate probably four people, right? Same for a rented, same for a unfurnished. And you pay for that based on your OPEX in all of these three cases, and your CAPEX as well. But if you have to add to capacity, you really don't have that flexibility here. You have to literally buy another new apartment to make that happen, right? So over here, capacity is fixed. Here is flexible. Here is flexible as well. And over here, it's flexible to another extent, simply because if you say I have rented a hotel apartment right now and I need another room to accommodate two more people or five more people or 10 more people tomorrow, you can simply rent more apartments. You are not going to pay any additional overheads as far as all of these things are concerned, because if you notice here, you're not really liable to pay anything for all of the other services because everything is incorporated in that cost. The hotel manages the whole infrastructure, the hotel manages the whole show. All you need to do is pay for it and just not worry about it, right? You carry on with your personal work, you carry on with your, you just are responsible for your own belongings. Essentially, which could be your food, your clothes, etc., but nothing else, right? So over here, it's extra flexible, which means you can essentially plan for all of your capacity very well in this instance. Yes, it is flexible in both of these cases. You can plan for capacity as well, and over here it's fixed. You can't really change the capacity too much at all. Why did I explain all of this? Because I wanted to relate this to how technology stack really operates, right? So an owned apartment can be classified as physical hardware, right? In which essentially means that everything pertaining to a physical hardware, investment, capex, yes, furniture, yes, you need to buy, cleaning, maintenance, service charges, and capacity planning. All of this you can relate to things like how much of RAM do you need, how much of how much of operating system do you need to install, how many resources do you need to manage that hardware, how are you going to update the infrastructure, is it the latest version, how are you going to do patching, how are you going to do fault tolerance, security, everything else, right? So all of this is something that relates to as personal ownership when it comes to physical hardware. Second category is virtual machines, right? So over here, obviously you notice that you don't pay that capex, you don't, but you still, are responsible for quite a lot of things. You still need to formulate that environment for virtual machines. You still need to install the OS. You still need to run the database in the background, and you still need to manage those machines and secure those machines. Although you're not owning that hardware, you don't own that hardware, but you still are managing everything else related to that. So that's where virtual machines come into picture. Very similar to virtual machines, but a little more flexible when it comes to planning, when it comes to capacity, when it comes to all of the other things, is the fact that you don't really buy this add-on stuff as well, which means you don't buy furniture, you don't really have to deal with, let's say, service charges, you don't have to deal with capacity planning. You simply rent a furnished apartment and you can just keep adding on as much rented furnished apartments as you want, right? So if tomorrow you have a requirement for 10 users, you fire up 10 containers and all of those 10 containers will come fully packaged with all of this. You will not need to buy additional stuff, to make that happen. And at the same time, you can add as many more and scale down just by paying lesser OPEX at a given point in time. As far as serverless is concerned, this is the last category, serverless. Serverless essentially does not hold you liable for any of these things at all, right? All you do is worry about paying a monthly charge, which is this charge. Maybe it's higher in comparison to this and this. Yes, it may be higher that way. However, the flexibility that you get, when it comes to serverless is the fact that you don't have to worry about managing anything about the infrastructure. Right, so you don't worry about which OS, you don't worry about how much capacity to plan. All that it does from a management perspective is just listens to the business, listens to the requirement of a user. You relate to the previous example in my other video where I spoke about a website going from 10,000 users to 50,000 users and how that serverless infrastructure can relate to it and add more on demand and then scale down when it comes to not needed for the business anymore. This is precisely what can be related to when it comes to a serviced hotel apartment, very closely related. Obviously all of those things don't really match as word for word as I explained, but you get the idea. You get to feel the difference between all of these four environments and why we've gone from physical hardware to VMs to containers to serverless. And this is what I wanted to talk about today. In the future videos, I will probably touch on some more add-on factors as to what categories of technology has evolved in what way. Just having rented furnished apartment is not enough. You need to have enough rented apartment furnished at scale and quickly and in an automated way and by leveraging as much efficiency and productivity as possible. So I'm going to touch on some more of those concepts which relate more to the technology side as opposed to this example, but this is the attempt that I wanted to make today. Please let me know how you find this video. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel, and I'll make sure to continue to do what I do, which is create more content like this. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye bye.